What's going on, Reject Nation? Greg Alba sitting down now.
And John Humphrey sitting up straight.
American Assassin, Red Band.
Tactical.
What'd you think? You're gonna jump from cell to cell taking out terrorists.
For starters, yeah.
Our people here like your agenda, Mitch. I know exactly what to do with you.
What do I need to know about this guy?
He's a warrior. One of the best I've ever known.
Some bad shit happened to you. Now you want to go kill terrorists, am I right?
Out there, it's about the mission, not about you.
Slice a man's throat right here like this.
He's testing for the roof. Speed, focus. He's off the charts.
I've seen off the charts before.
Not like this.
You think you're special? Never, ever let it get personal. What is it you think we do here?
Kill people who need to be killed.
We got a problem. 6 days ago, 15 kilos of plutonium went missing.
Take a look at this.
It can't be him.
It's him, Irene. It's Ghost.
Ghost.
Ghost. Why does this guy have to you? Some personal sin?
Nice. Everything he did there, I taught him how to do it.
There's a fucking nuke in play.
We got 48 hours
to stop him.
I trusted you.
You should have come for me.
Eliminate the target.
Yes, sir.
Damn! Whoa!
Where's the rest of your team?
Ouch! Ow.
Craziness going on, man.
Yeah.
This whole thing is just a mean to an end for you, isn't it?
No. This is just the beginning.
I love cold-blooded assassins.
Really, now? That's a... Where does that come from?
Childhood.
All those Richard Kuklinski documentaries, that one. What did we learn today?
I learned that I like it when celebrities fight for top billing. This character is Mitch Rapp, who is Dylan O'Brien. He is the American Assassin.
He's the lead of this film.
And then his name is, if you go left to right, that's how you read.
First.
But we're going to put Michael Keaton's name there as well, but put just a little bit on top, but to the right. So it looks like they're kind of equal with the top billing situation.
I think they should just start putting them on top of each other. Yeah. The next Rush Hour movie should have just a Jackie Chan, Chris Tucker, so you can't even read
it. I remember that Rush Hour 2, like the DVDs and VHSs would switch between who gets top billing.
Yeah.
Anyway, but the movie looks good. I mean, I like the first trailer that we got. I like the first trailer a little bit more, honestly. I know this is a Red Band that gives you a little bit more insight into how the violence
more. Just getting tons more. Yeah. By the end of this trailer, it's changed the scope of the movie that I was expecting.
Yeah, it's much bigger.
Like, I was expecting more of a grounded, like, not, you know, kind of something with a Bourne, like, tone, maybe a little grittier, more harsh, you know, but this looks fucking insane.
It does. Like, Dylan O'Brien's gonna kill this role.
Yeah, this is his John Wick.
This is John Wick as Jason Bourne. Seems like a little bit of a hybrid of both when it comes to the espionage aspect.
Yeah, yeah, with a healthy dose
of it's like if John Wick was a spy.
Yeah, John Wick had a government tie instead of a personal just
the crime gig. World tie. I did a tiny bit of research on this. I know this is based on a book, and when I found that out, I was like, okay, don't do too much research on it, because if you like, even if you just like Wikipedia, you're like, oh, I'm gonna hear what the whole movie's about.
Yeah,
getting in.
The story will be well documented.
On the research I did do of it, this is not the first installment of the book. There's a book series, and then the American Assassin was a prequel for the character. So they actually started with the prequel, and I like what they're doing with they intentionally hired Dylan O'Brien because he's young, so they want him to like age throughout the series.
Damn.
And I thought that was a really cool idea.
So is he going to be doing this forever? Are they going to like take breaks?
Yeah, if the movie's a hit and stuff. Yeah, if the movie's a hit, they want to do more of this. I mean, this is a story that's been having. Like, it's been, like, a decade they've been trying to get this thing done.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And they keep switching directors and writers, and then they finally got it made. Chris Hemsworth was originally attached to star in it, which would have been a very different look.
Yeah, a different movie, yeah.
Super buff version of this guy.
Yeah. Maybe it's good it came together now. Yeah. Like, because I like all the elements they have combined, and, I mean, this trailer just sells me that much more on Dylan O'Brien.
Yeah, and I like the story of why he's becoming the assassin. From what I gather from the trailer, at least, was that he's out with his girlfriend, and then these terrorists attack, and then he gets recruited by as one of the people who's like a victim of the terrorist attack.
Probably wanted to do something about that.
Yeah, know? Exactly. So as much as like the theme of the trailer is don't get personal about stuff, it's a very personal. Yeah, it's 100% personal. His whole motivation for all this is very personal.
The whole trailer, I was thinking, oh man, it's a thin line between you and Ghost.
Yeah.
Be careful. And this trailer also gives us a better idea of where the actual story is going. Because the first trailer was like, oh, here's the situation, here's the training, but I'm like, what is the mission? And it looks like there's a whole bunch of mission in here.
There's a lot of mission. It makes it clear on, I haven't read the book, and I didn't read much about what goes on in the book, because I didn't want anything ruined. Because when I saw the first trailer, I was like, is Michael Keaton a bad guy? And this trailer makes it clear that he's not a bad guy.
Yeah.
And I like that aspect, because it gets me excited for the chemistry that will ignite between him and Dylan O'Brien. Because, you know, Michael Keaton at one point, is like, he looks captured and beaten up by this ghost character. Is that Taylor Kitsch?
Taylor Kitsch.
Yeah. And
he's old Gambit himself.
Yeah. So the fact that he's all beaten up and possibly kidnapped gives insight like, oh, he's probably not a bad guy in this. I'm probably going to go into this film now really looking forward to their chemistry. It makes sense whether it be the top billing battle going on.
Yeah, totally. And I mean, you know, there's a seniority element for Michael Keaton. And Michael Keaton tends to show up and kill it, especially lately. Like, since his career's had a resurgence, like, he's always fun to watch, and he always brings... At least right now, he always seems to bring his A-game.
Our next old guy action hero. Our
next old guy action hero. This Spider-Man Garrett.
Yeah.
The only, like, flag it raised for me is just, like, seeing so much crazy action and seeing, you know, especially some of those later shots of, like, bombs exploding, submarines and things. I'm like, how big is this gonna get?
I don't want it to get carried away in action. The fact that this is based on a very specific book series is obviously people aren't, like, hooked in the book series because of its description of actions.
Young adults!
Like, I'm sure people are hooked because of this character, because of Mitch Rapp. I really want them to make sure that, you know, they're calling this an American Assassin. It sounds like it could be a partial character study. I'm assuming that if it's a book, yes, you have the espionage, tactical missions, and all that. However, you still gotta make sure that this character is someone we could hook into for a franchise. Because we're all used to cool action. While the action here looks cool, it doesn't look exactly unique by any standards.
Yeah, it just looks like the flavor of now, that sort of hyper-tactical, very hard-hitting, like, ooh, like, cringy. But yeah, it's impressive right now, but the more of these we get, you know, you're gonna have to have other stuff. And I hope that this doesn't devolve into violence porn, just because of the subject matter, too. It's like, even if... This isn't a true story or anything, is it? Is it?
It's based on my life.
Gregory Albertale. But even so, it's borrowing from a lot of very real imagery and a very real situations. You know, like we have terrorist problems and counter-strikes all over the world every day. Yeah, so that's the only, like, fear I have with movies like these is when you got all that fucking awesome action and craziness going on. I just hope it doesn't devolve into that. Like, I hope that it you know, justifies its point or its message or whatever.
Yeah.
But otherwise, I mean, holy shit.
Yeah, it looks like... I'm sure it's going to be a cool film. And Dylan O'Brien friends are freak friends. Dylan O'Brien fans are freaking out over this movie.
Oh, yeah, man. I got bruises just watching this.
All right, guys. Are you excited for The American Assassin? Another movie with American in the title, meaning... It's about corruption.
It's about the corruption of the American ideal.
Subscribe to The Real Rejects. Click that notification bell. Dat John Humphrey on Twitter and Instagram. Social media manager at Blumhouse. And you can check out our exclusive perks and video content at patreon.com/therealrejects. Good day. Right.